San Diego, that's how they want to more.
Well, it's like all over through Sacramento. It goes like.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. The same river?
Yeah. It's called American River.
Huh?
American River.
American River.
Julie brought her to her school, Max Josh Law School.
Good luck with all those girls.
That's how they want to more.
Well, it's like all over through Sacramento. It goes like.
Oh, right?
Yeah.
The same river?
Yeah. It's called American River.
Huh?
American River.
Julie brought her to her school, Max Josh Law School.
Good luck with all those girls.
So where you had classes?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. You sit there everywhere you want, or sit one spot all the time?
Well,
I like to sit here. This is my spot.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. How many students?
Like 80.
Oh, 80?
Yeah, you plug in your laptop.
Go. High tech, man. Yes,
it's exactly the same.
Where's Jenny?
No, đi từ yếu tệ.
Did she find the bathroom?
Nó hỏi ông nó.
Julie, you know what? I have that. You told my guest the first night time thing.
Oh, you have it?
Yeah.
How do you have it?
Yeah, I didn't know that they have free shopping.
Rồi chụp đi, chụp đi. Đứng đứng.
1 2 3.
Chưa đứng à, chụp ngay đứng. Cái gì đâu, không sao đâu. Không sao đâu, đứng đứng đây nè. Đây là đứng hàng đây nè. Đứng đứng đây chụp. Đó. Thấy 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 thấy. Thấy Yuli chụp không? Yuli chụp không? Yuli chụp không?
Here's Jenny.
Đi đi.
Yuli có dám, Yuli ơi.
À, đứng đứng chỗ này nè, chụp chụp cái này cái nè. Đó.
Where's mom? Mom!
Come, that's okay. No, don't need to be on the list or anything. Inside?
You'll see it tomorrow, Dad.
Inside? Okay. Where hotel?
Oh, let me show you.
Okay.
So we can walk?
Yes, you can walk there. That's why I picked this hotel. So you're not going to be late.
Hotel at all.
Right here, Quality Inn.
Oh, okay.
Hết nhiệm kỳ rồi. Hình như ra mà em nhìn như không ra sao?
Chưa bầu, sao chưa biết được. Chưa bầu. Ông làm dở quá.
Mà biết đâu chắc cũng thắng là tại vì có tiền.
Sẽ thấy gì vậy bạn?
Làm mà không có làm mà thâm thục quá chừng mà. Cái này nó tựa tựa giống như Washington đó hả? Cái kịch. Bà quay đi, bà quay Capitol.
Assembly district.
Today is the Julie Creation Day. Today is the Creation Day. Pacific, Senior University of Pacific, Commencement. Maxwell Law, School of Law. How at the Sacramento Memorial Auditorium. We try to get online now, it's 11:30. Start to get inside.
Tàu mà tàu với Ấn Độ, mấy thằng tàu với thằng Ấn Độ chứ không có thấy Việt Nam. Tên mà ra trường chỉ có Julie với lại một đứa trên
phòng. Research and study number 56. mất long luôn nó phải xuất hiện theo xe 555 Lady Bird School of Education 524 Major Law School 524 Accusation School of Dentistry 896 Conversation Music 1878 University of Library 1851 College of Pacific 1857
Thank you.
Dr. Patrick Farrillo, Dean of the Arc identified individually in your program, and I'd like to invite them as well to stand for well-deserved recognition. This is their day as much as it is our graduates. who will convey her personal congratulations to the class of 2010. Dr. Ibeck is the 24th president of the University of the Pacific. Presidency follows a distinguished career. A tenured researcher and teacher at the University of California, Berkeley, and an educational reformer and university administrator at Northern Arizona University, and finally, dean of the Edward E. Whitaker Jr. College of Engineering at Texas Tech University, one of the nation's largest engineering colleges. President Ibeck holds a bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degree in mechanical engineering from Stanford. He's a fellow of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers and has received a Distinguished Engineering Educator Award from the Society of Women Engineers. This commencement marks Dr. Ibeck's first academic year as our president. It's a year that saw record undergraduate applications, nearly 20,000 total, and sound finances. President Ibeck has dedicated considerable time this year to a listening campaign, spending time on all three of Pacific's campuses and traveling coast to coast to engage our alumni. In honor, the university hosted a year-long presidential inaugural series. These events highlighted the university's history and traditions, its robust strength today, and its promising future. And several of these wonderful events were sponsored by Pacific with George, including our fifth National Ethics Trial Competition, a symposium on the Italian criminal justice system and the development of international criminal courts, and a lecture by renowned author Michael Pollan in celebration of Pacific's first sustainability month. These events demonstrate President Ibeck's and the university's deep commitment to hold Pamela A. Ibeck, the 24th president of the University of Pacific. Congratulations, graduates. Friends and family, the day you've been waiting for has arrived. How do you feel? Good to hear. Thank you to our distinguished Board of Regents, our energetic Dean, Elizabeth Parker, and her team, our inspiring speaker, the Honorable Daryl Sundberg. This is my first commencement as president of the University of Pacific and my first opportunity to preside over the McGeorge School of Law's diploma and pudding ceremony. I am honored today to confer degrees upon our very deserving graduates and to pay tribute to our world-class faculty and dedicated staff. This has been a terrific first year in office, and I thank you for making Bill and me welcome. Reflecting on this year, early in my presidency, I had the opportunity to celebrate Constitution Day with you, and your longtime faculty member, U.S. Supreme Court Justice Anthony Kennedy. It was fitting and symbolic to have Justice Kennedy help us break ground on the new Pacific McGeorge Legal Studies Center, uniting the school's exceptional past with its promising future. The singularity of this year continued when I joined Pacific's delegation to the third annual Clinton Global Initiative for Universities. The Clinton Global Initiative University brings together students and university leaders from a variety of disadvantaged youth. With the support and patronage of the Boosters family, of Boosters Media, Jeanette pursued her undergraduate and graduate degrees. In college at UCLA, she organized a bilingual conference to explain community prospective students. At McGeorge, she has worked as a tutor and mentor in the Pipeline Project and the Street Law Program. As Vice President of Your Latino Law Students Program Association, Jeanette also mentored incoming Latino students. I'm sure some of you in the audience this afternoon benefited firsthand from her support. After graduation, Jeanette intends to continue her advocacy. Professionally, she aspires to advance the legal rights of underrepresented groups, perhaps as a plaintiff's trial attorney or in politics. Jeanette also plans to devote spare time to community education, working to. So you've heard the story of just two of your colleagues' commitment. And it's time to ask, what will your commitment be? As lawyers and as citizens, what matters to you? McGeorge graduates understand that your work has moral implications. After all, your training emphasizes ethical reasoning. Think of the Ethics Across the Professions Initiative or your annual sponsorship of the National Ethics Trial Competition. You also know that the firm commitment to campus sustainability. Now, as individuals, how will you take your legal education with its social and ethical lessons and use it to satisfy your commitment to better the world, to transform the world before and make a difference? Thank you, President Obama. Thank you for your leadership, and thank you for being as president on our campus as I think I have ever recalled a university official being. It's a wonderful opportunity to join forces as a university with the power that gives us. Our graduating class traditionally selects three class members. Membership to the Roger J. Traynor Honor Society and was elected to the Order of the Void yesterday. He's a member as well of our nationally ranked mock trial competition team. Mr. Jackson.
Thank you, Parker, for that kind introduction. Good afternoon, graduates, faculty, family, and friends. It's an honor to be here with you today, but I have to admit, it's a bit overwhelming standing on the stage looking out of this group right here. I don't think I've seen so many overachievers in one place before. I've promised some people that I would refrain from what I did. It truly is a time to celebrate. Law school has been a challenging, crazy, rewarding adventure. I remember being my first year at George, sitting in class and just being so intimidated by all the smart, successful people in my classroom. And by the professor who was asking questions in a way people were calling the Socratic method. I didn't really have much familiarity with Socrates, but the room had taken a chance on us. They believed in us. Let's not let them down. Let's not let ourselves down, because we know what we are capable of. Let's show the people in this room that they made the right choice to believe in us and invest in our future. Let's be the leaders of our profession. Who will the members of our community turn to when they're hoping to start their own business and want to know what their options are? Who will they turn to when the world is turned upside down because they've been injured in a terrible accident? And they need someone to help them get their lives back on track. Who will they turn to when they have to stand up against the awesome power of the government? They'll need an advocate, a champion, and they'll be looking to us. And I know that when that time comes, we will be ready for the challenge. This school is training school. Now, there's a reason why law school isn't easy. I like to think of law school kind of like a boot camp for nerds. The sweat, the tears, and the determination. And I joked when I first got up and I called you all overachievers. But class of 2010, that is exactly what this country needs right now. Now is not the time for mediocrity. Now is the time for excellence. Now is the time for the overachievers. When we step out of this auditorium, we meet as new people who have been refined and molded to do great things. People out there are going to need leaders, but they don't need to look any further than this room right here. We will face endless problems that we will have to solve, but graduates, that's exactly what we have been doing. So go enjoy the day. Let your grandmother take 1,000 pictures of you. Enjoy the wine and cheese at the reception, and remember the journey you have made and the people you have become. Thank you.
Pacific McGeorge, she won a membership in the Roger J. Traynor Honor Society and was also They humble me. The last, simultaneously making the commitment it takes to get through this seem impossible, yet the option of walking away, unacceptable. My friend Lilica reminded me how lucky we are to have you here today. Far too many of our classmates lost parents while earning their degree. Their strength in returning to class, picking up the book, and continuing the work was inspiring to us who could only watch with heavy hearts. No doubt their parents are proud. Our families, you have supported us, and you have missed us. I get to be a little selfish here. I want to thank my husband, Russ, who earned this degree right along with me. I also want to thank my mom, who over the past 4 years has taught me about motherhood, that even if you think what your kid is doing is nuts, if it's their choice, you support them, and she absolutely has. Over the past 4 years, this class committed itself to becoming lawyers. Every night, fighting rush hour traffic, missing dinners to make it to class, to study. They dedicated themselves to the law, understanding its application and its power. They are a truly inspiring, amazing, courageous woman. And they are who I would want as my lawyer, no doubt. Recognize their accomplishment. You know, these speeches are not a total surprise. I've heard both speak before. And so, I know you've chosen wisely. And in our third speaker, I think the same will be true. Representing the Elma class is Grace Gotabalu. Grace is a native of Kenya, of French nationality, who speaks five languages. She studied at the University of Paris, the Sorbonne, majoring in English and North American Business Law. She also has a degree in international private practice. She receives her Master's of Law degree today in the teaching of advocacy. Mrs. Gautamal.
The campus of the university gives us free pizzas.
go anywhere. And I urge you, new graduates, to take this step abroad for a study, work, and don't forget that you now have colleagues all over the world, and you'll all be there for you. So if you have a venture, scholarship, or projects, whatever it is, or even if you choose to travel.
$65,000
raised.
understanding that this university, this law school succeeds because it is a community. We must all be part of it. Now, then we turn to something else that I don't like to talk about. It's the U.S. News ranking system. I don't think this ranking system deserves the time of day, but there is one thing worthy of note on this occasion. This year, we were ranked 5th in the nation for our advocacy program. And this rank is not just a reputational contest. Who has the biggest, best-known football team? Who's aligned with the largest university, research university name recognition, and so on? Rather, this is an award that I believe happens because others working in advocacy observe the students we produce. And so students, graduates of class of 2010, celebrate the fact that you are critically responsible for this acknowledgement of the quality that you represent. Thank you.
By Daniel. The battle.